If you're tired of your kids, or your siblings for that matter, using your Quest 2 account and messing with your saved games...
This is not where I left off.
Your high scores...
Oh, come on, I'm never gonna be able to beat that.
Your friends list, or whatever...
Who the flip is Golden Ponyboy 128?
Well, then it's probably time to get them set up with their own account. As of the making of this video, they will have to set up a Facebook account for this. But supposedly, sometime in the future, this requirement will go away. Anyway, the Quest 2 allows you to have up to 4 user accounts on a single headset. 1 administrator account, and 3 additional accounts. The nice thing about each user having their own account is they can then have their own friends lists, their own saved game progress, their own high scores, and even their own games. Adding new accounts to your headset is super easy. Once you're powered on and logged into your administrator account, you'll click on the time here to bring up the quick settings. And then click on the settings cog here in the upper right of the menu, then on accounts. You then click on the add account button here at the top, and then on continue. Your Quest 2 will then restart and bring you to the login page where whoever is being added can input their Facebook account information. Now when you turn on your Quest 2, you'll be greeted by this, where you can choose continue and log in as the administrator, or choose switch user and log into one of your other accounts. If you're already logged into an account and want to switch, you can do that by simply clicking on your profile picture here in the navigation bar. Yeah, I know, my avatar. My daughters have pretty much commandeered my account, if you couldn't tell. Click switch account here, and then you can select the account you want to log into. When we were in the accounts menu a little while ago, you may have noticed the toggle here for app sharing. Turning this on will allow apps that were purchased on the administrator's account to be shared with all other accounts that are logged into the headset. So you don't necessarily need to buy all your games over again. You will be able to share most of them with the other accounts on your headset by turning this on. There are some games that do not support app sharing, however, so for other users to play those particular games, they are going to have to purchase that game on their account. From what I can tell, based on the apps my family and I own, the majority of apps out there do support app sharing. That being said, there are some limitations to app sharing that you should be aware of. For example, we have 2 Quest 2 headsets, and both of them have my account as the administrator account. We also have my wife's account on 1 of the headsets, and when my daughters want to play Beat Saber together, in order for them to play together, one of them has to be logged in as me and the other as my wife. App sharing works great in this instance because we only had to purchase Beat Saber once for this to work. However, on my account we also own some of the additional music packs, and these cannot be shared between accounts. So in order for my daughters to be able to play any of the additional music pack songs together, we had to turn app sharing off, purchase another copy of Beat Saber on my wife's account, and purchase the additional music packs as well. Another example of the limits to app sharing I've come across is in a game called Locodojo. If you haven't heard of it, it's a really fun multiplayer game that reminds me a lot of the Mario Party games, but I digress. Once again, my daughters were trying to play the game together, but they were unable to join each other's games. They could play solo at the same time using app sharing, but unlike Beat Saber, it would not allow them to play with each other. For them to be able to play together, we again had to turn off app sharing and purchase another copy of Locodojo on my wife's account. So I guess the moral of the story is, if you're playing solo, app sharing works great, but when it comes to online multiplayer with your family members, then depending on the game you're playing, you may need to purchase another copy on your other account. Yes, it does suck having to purchase games multiple times like this, but on the bright side, when a game is already installed to the headset, it does not have to install a second copy for another account. Meaning, if a game takes up 4 gigabytes of space on your headset, it will not install a second copy and then take up 8 gigabytes. It will recognize you already have the game installed and will continue to only occupy 4 gigabytes of your headset storage space.